Welcome to Science Camp. I know things look a little different this year, pretty much all over the world, but there are some things that we can count on always staying the same, and that's God's love and His word and promises. And I'm excited that I get to share those things with you. What a comfort to have God during this time. Now, as you know, this year's Science Camp is all about being in quarantine, and the day one theme is diagnosis. God gave us a very special gift through the Jewish prophet Moses to help show us how to have a happy, healthy, and God-pleasing life. So let's begin with prayer. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. Y'all, I am so excited to share today's lesson with you. It comes from the book of Exodus in the Bible, and it's one of my go-to books of the Bible. To read about the trials and the struggles that the Israelites went through to get to the promised land really puts life into perspective. We could chat for hours about the adventures that happen in Exodus, but today we're really going to focus on Moses' 40 days and 40 nights on Mount Sinai. Our lesson comes from Exodus 24, verses 12 through 18, which we will read in just a bit, but first I want to give you a little background on how we got here. Moses was born to a Levite woman, a Jewish woman, but was raised by Pharaoh's daughter. Moses grew up with all the wealth and the privilege of the Egyptian king, but after witnessing the mistreatment of the Jewish slaves, Moses kills an Egyptian, and in fear for his life and Pharaoh's revenge, he flees the land. During his time away from Egypt, Moses gets married, has a son, and becomes the shepherd over his father-in-law's flock. It's during this time that God first speaks to Moses through the burning bush and tells Moses he wants him to lead his people out of Egypt to the promised land. Amazing things happen to Moses and the Israelites, but we need to jump ahead to get to Mount Sinai. From Exodus chapter 24, verses 12 through 18, we read, "The Lord said to Moses, 'Come up to me on the mountain and stay here, and I will give you the tablets of stone with the law and the commandments I have written for their instruction.' Then Moses set out with Joshua his aide, and Moses went up to the mountain of God. He said to the elders, 'Wait here for us until we come back to you. Aaron and Hur are with you, and anyone involved in a dispute can go to them.' When Moses went up to the mountain, the cloud covered it, and the glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai. For 6 days the cloud covered the mountain, and on the seventh day, the Lord called to Moses from within the cloud. To the Israelites, the glory of the Lord looked like a consuming fire on top of the mountain. Then Moses entered the cloud as he went up on the mountain. And he stayed on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. The Lord gave Moses the Ten Commandments for the Israelites and for us to help recognize or diagnose our sins. For instance, do we always put God first as we're instructed in the first commandment? Are we excited to get up early on Sunday for Sunday school and services? We're told to in the third commandment. And the fourth commandment says to honor our parents and those in authority. Sometimes we need a reminder of God's expectations. When we are sinful and don't do things that are pleasing to God, it hurts our relationship. It does damage to our relationship with God and our parents and other family members and even our friends. It's not fun to look at the bad things that we have done, but it is necessary so that we can heal. When we look at the things that we've done wrong, we can figure out why we did those things, how we can make those things better with the people that we hurt, and hopefully how to avoid doing them again in the future. Fortunately, we have God on our side to show us the way. So use this wonderful gift that God gave us through Moses to live a God-pleasing life. Let's close in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for your laws. Thank you for guiding us in what is pleasing in your sight. Bless all those who hear your word and follow your path. Amen. Thanks so much for joining me today. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them here or send an email to office@bslc.us. And in the subject line, write, "Question for Miss Kathy." I will see you guys all again tomorrow.